Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this question, we have been given this amplitude modulated signal and we have been asked to find the ratio of the power of this message signal to the power of the carrier signal. So here, this is the modulated signal. And if you see this equation, then it is not given in the standard format. And if you are aware, then the standard amplitude modulated signal can be given by this expression. That is AC plus MT times cos of omega CT, where AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal, while MT is the message signal. Now, if you look this equation, then here all the terms are the cosine terms. It means that it is the case of the tone modulation. So here, let us assume that here this MT is equal to AM times cos of omega MT. And first of all, let us simplify this standard equation. So further, if we simplify it, then we can write it as AC times cos of omega CT plus MT times cos of omega CT. And if we assume that this MT is also sinusoidal signal, then further this expression can be written like this, where this MT is equal to AM times cos of omega MT. And further, if we simplify this term, then we can write this expression as AC times cos of omega CT plus 1 by 2 times AM times cos of omega C minus omega MT plus AM by 2 times cos of omega C plus omega M T. So because of this term, we will get the two more terms. So after the simplification, we have a three frequency components. That is omega C minus omega M and omega C plus omega M. So this omega C plus omega M will have the highest frequency, while this omega C minus omega M will have the lowest frequency. So equating this term with the given modulated signal, we can say that here this AC cos of omega CT is equal to 4 times cos of 2400 pi T, right? So from this we can say that here AC is equal to 4 and this omega C is equal to 2400 pi, right? Similarly, if we equate this term with this term, then we can say that AM by 2 times cos of omega C minus omega M is equal to cos of 2000 by T. That means here AM divided by 2 is equal to 1, or we can say that here amplitude of this message signal is equal to 2. That means here the amplitude of this carrier signal is equal to 4, while the amplitude of this message signal is equal to 2. That means here carrier signal C of T is equal to 4 times cos of 2400 pi t, while the message signal MT is equal to 2 times cos of 400 pi t. Because here if you see, this omega C minus omega M is equal to 2000 pi, and since the omega C is equal to 2400 pi, that means omega M is equal to 400 pi. So from this we can say that this message signal MT is equal to 2 cos 400 pi T, right? And now, since we know the carrier signal and the message signal, so we can find the power of each signal. So here, the power of this carrier signal is equal to AC square divided by 2R. Because here, since we don't know the value of the load, so we can consider it as a R. That is equal to 4 square divided by 2R. That is equal to 8 divided by R. And similarly, the power of this message signal is equal to AM square divided by 2R. That is equal to 2 square divided by 2R. That is equal to 2 divided by R. That means the ratio of this power of the message signal to the carrier signal is equal to 2 divided by R divided by 8 divided by R. That is equal to 1 by 4. Or we can say that it is equal to 0.250. Now here, if someone finds the power of the message signal from these two terms, then it will be actually the sideband power. Because here, the message signal is getting multiplied with the carrier signal. So from these two terms, we directly cannot find the power of the message signal. And here, we actually need to find the exact expression of the message signal. And from that, we can find the power of the message signal. That means here, the ratio of the power of the message signal to the carrier signal is equal to 0.250. And hence, for the given question, we can say that C is the correct answer.